Hello everyone and welcome to another video of mine where we're going to discuss Dollar Franc today. But before we move on, just a quick reminder alerting you here about this week's situation, right? First of all, we have July 4th in the States, which definitely means less volatility. And today, Monday, we have bank holiday in Canada as well, so be aware of that before you move on. Sorry about the phone. Then back to the chart, guys, okay? Not this one, that one. So first of all, let's go to the scanner. As you can see, we have some opportunities on the list, but I would like to talk specifically about the dollar franc. Short-term opportunity, daily didn't yet switch. I do expect it to switch to bearish. Okay, so within a few days we're going to get here the arrow as well, but let's focus on the short term. First of all, 4-hour charting combo with the 30 or the 15 minute, we are looking now for actual entries. Okay, so going back to the chart, starting with the 4-hour, what we can see here is that the price pushed lower, created the delta pattern, and this is where the hidden divergence appeared. Okay, this is the 61.8 level. After the pullback, now we can recognize it, and now we're going towards the 100. So basically, classical ABCD pattern is about to form. Now the trend line from the top doesn't really fit here. Okay, the trend line fits more or less with the 161.8, but this is perfectly fine. Why? Because we're not looking for extended moves and legs, we're looking for equal legs, which would be the ABCD, that means 100. Then we have this zone right here, which I marked for you from the daily chart and the weekly chart. So this is a perfect one, coming together with the 100 zone. And then the hidden divergence is now starting to push and create some sort of continuing divergence here, which is not yet completed. Okay, it's still pushing upwards, but you get the point. The pressure, the bearish pressure, is definitely there. And now we're using the checklist indicator here. We can see that hard time frame divergence against is set to no, right? The X button. Why? Because we actually have divergence with us. So hard time frame hidden divergence with us is set to true, yes. Price near a level, yes, definitely, right here. And you can see that this setup is now turning into conservative setup, which means the recommendation would say look for entries. This is basically a tradable situation. So what are we looking for? Now we can drop to the 30 minute or the 15 minute chart, doesn't really matter. And we start looking for entries. Whether you're looking for divergences, trend line breakouts, whether you're looking for the software's setup, which is basically this kind of setup, divergence, breakout, and continuation, which is more or less the most conservative way to go ahead and trade it, doesn't really make much difference here. Okay, we know the direction, which is bearish, we just need to know how to enter. And again, you can go ahead and do it by literally thousands of ways. It just depends on your preferences, it depends on your risk profile, whether you want to be more conservative, whether you want to be more aggressive, risk reward ratio, and so on and so forth. So that's about it, guys. Hopefully we're going to get something here within today or tomorrow. Ideally, of course, we want to see that zone tested, so something like this to happen. And from this level, once we clear some stops here and so on, false breaks to appear, and then looking for the sells. Alright, so that would be all. If you have any questions, please leave your comments below and I will be happy to reply. Of course, don't forget to join us in the Telegram groups. You can find the link below in the comments. Thank you for watching.